There are these like very lawful, like gravity laws that can control behavior and help you shape your destiny to go from being kicked out of Disney to then maybe operating a company during a pandemic with over 600 or 700 employees. And none of that really matters. What I care about the most is my family and then everyone else's family and then helping them.
Over here we feel equal, feel like a family that'll never leave you. We ride hard for the boss, but the boss go for his people. I said our style ain't to ever boast, but we expanded up and down the coast. Starting a business, you always want to grow. Come, I'll teach you the ropes. We try and make change in the world. Really, why you think that we in it for? Yo, BDA gotta win it. We grew during the pandemic. Ayo, we all in this together. Phoenix rises through ashes, through any storm we can weather. Now watch us thrive in our classes.
If your values are strong and you lean into your values during this period of time and the science, so if you take your values, which we have pictures everywhere because that's all I stare at is when things get tough, reminding myself of the values and then the science that drives it. I mean, there's nothing you can't accomplish. Law number one, where like you pinpoint, what is the result or the key performance indicator? What am I looking for? What do I want to achieve? Making it measurable. And then simply trying to determine when you pinpoint what you want. And for me, all I wanted was my family back and to have a place to sleep and to help people, you know? So pinpoint. So all you gotta do is really, that's the hardest part, pinpointing what you really want. What is your why? What's your why? What one or two behaviors can you engage in repeatedly that will help you achieve that desirable key performance indicator? Law two, you goal set, which is a condition, I mean, which is a discriminative stimulus. When you goal set and you make that damn thing visual and you rehearse it regularly, you have that discriminative stimulus that you're shooting for. And make it as visual and as you can and rehearse it. And I mean, it's not like some kind of law of attraction thing where you don't have to do anything, you just stare at a goal. You know, it's like engaging you when you have that goal so crystal clear of what you want and your why, you end up flowing because you're not having to think about every micro action you engage in. You just flow and you become yourself and you become genuine because you know what you want. Purpose. Law number three, in order to be independent, you got to self-monitor. So self-monitoring, whether on your phone or in whatever capacity, you self-monitor by making some kind of permanent product, whether it's a text or a checklist. And then knowing, law number three, that you gotta self-monitor and report it out to someone who gives a shit. Someone who cares. Someone who's gonna hold you accountable. That's law three. You'd self-monitor it in some way, report it out. And then law four is just getting feedback, reciprocal feedback. That person should ask questions. You should respond back. And then you get this reciprocal feedback going on, which helps shape your future. And then the fifth law, clearly just being pay for performance, which is really just reinforcement, positive reinforcement. So people have to realize though that, like, you know, what Paulie, I got mad respect for Paulie Gavoni, Dr. Paul Gavoni. When he broke these things down, he gave so many examples that are not about money. Pay for performance is not about money. It's just a payoff for your behavior, a reinforcer. And that matters because for me, like I said before, what mattered most to me is seeing Olivia DiNovi, being able to see her and get out of my problems at the Montessori school and just hold her and love her. And she had it more together than I did. But you know, your pay for performance is not always money. It's function based.
Phoenix rising through ashes, through any storm we can weather. Now watch us thrive in our classes. Hey.